questions. Okay, two questions. Because I think there's a slight mistake in your presentation, which I do not like. Okay? You don't have a question, doesn't matter. I will show you the questions on the board. I want to talk why you're going to make the same mistake right at home.
Therefore, for example, if I say a
minus B. This is negative. How to get remove the mod?
B minus A,
right? If it's negative, we call B minus A, right? Okay, alright, so this is your question 6. Now, next one is your question. I hope now if I can't remember which one. Question 14. Yes. Are you not talking about a lot of you forgot what you need for sketching. Now, this is in your e-labs. I just told myself why I throw them out. Alright, now. This one, glowing car. So, x minus 3, x plus 2, alright. So, this one, it will become like that. This is a negative 12, this is a 3. Now, this one is a negative 6, right? When x is 0. Now, I told you already, besides the x intercept, the y intercept, you must still indicate the maximum or minimum point. This one is actually half and one. Negative 6.5 or negative 6.25. Do you understand my concept here? Yes or no? Okay, then I want to say something that you all are very fond of. Now, they say, what did the question say? Can you tell me what's the question part 2? They say, I don't know, okay. Hence find the area of the region bounded by the curve and the x-axis of the board here. Bounded by the curve and x-axis. They want this one, actually. Do you understand what I'm talking about? They want this one, okay? Now, actually, they are not too clear here. Let me just check. Sketch the curve, hence find the area of region bounded by the curve and the x-axis, they should say below the x-axis. Because if not, later people, this one is also, here also have one. Today is forever. You see, I'm looking at one. Okay, so then I will take this. Now, I want to tell you, because it's like that, right? You just need to integrate from negative 2 to 3 here, right?
Yes.
Then you mod it, right?
Yes.
I don't understand why that is. That's why I put up there wide up here. You integrate from negative 2 to 0. Then 0 to 3. If you get what I'm talking about, I don't understand. Then you must now integrate from negative 2 to negative 1. Then negative 1 to 0. 0 to 1. 1 to 2. Then 2 to 3. You hear what I'm saying? So don't root like that. Do you understand what I'm saying? If it's continuous, you just integrate. Understand? But this one you must mount it because it's below the curve. Understand? But do you agree that there's something not too right about the question down there? Because the two parts, they extend it so it can be there. But of course, we don't read so much, but when it's in the exam, they'll qualify it. Everybody okay?
Yeah.
Roughly, this 90.1 is fine. We are fine with it. Everybody okay? I'm still starting to mark the 90.2. I'll give you slowly. Understand? So now I'll start revision, continue revision, not start revision. Continue revision for the second one. Huh? Okay, everybody okay?
Yes.
Call this up. Okay. Alright. Now, yesterday I stopped at a point whereby I say for factorization, there are four methods. Number one, common
factor.
Number two, number three,
cross method.
And number four, difference of two.
Okay.
This difference of two squares is actually this one. A minus B, right? Now, for cross method, I need to say one more thing before I come to you. Now, everybody look up here. If I do cross, this one is very easy. X minus 3 minus 2, right? So I have x minus 3, x minus 2, correct?
Uh-huh.
It's very easy, okay? Even if I teach a kindergarten, maybe you will know. Yes, okay, now look up here. What other types of expressions you can use cross method? Yes, this is a square.
Yeah.
This is a term itself, and it's a constant. And another one is this. This type also can. Can you see that this is a square, square, and a mixture?
Yeah.
Okay. will be xx, then 3y, 2y, right? Both negative, right?
Yeah.
Negative 3xy, negative 2xy, this is 5xy.
Okay.
So this is x minus 3y, x minus 2y. So this type also can use cross method. Don't say, oh, I only have that type of it. But of course, the most usual type is this one. Okay, now there's another type. This one also can. Okay, now why? This one become what? XY, XY, right?
Yes.
Okay, this one is
minus 3, minus
2. Minus 3, minus 2, right? Minus 3, XY, minus 2, XY, minus 5, XY. Yes, yes. Okay, so this is XY minus 3. XY minus 2. Can you see?
Yes.
These three types, all you can use cross method. Don't think that it's only that type. Everybody clear what I'm saying? And also be careful. When you have an expression, this is expression, it's not an equation. You cannot multiply throughout by negative 1. You cannot change the expression. Do you understand what I'm talking about here? So if this is negative, then how? Then one of them got to be negative. That's how you factorize. You cannot say, oh, they multiply by negative 1. No. Only is an equation that you can use. Everybody clear? Yes or no? Okay, now. Yeah. Alright, so this is for the cross method. Okay, now. Next one that I'm going to, because there are many things that I want to say today, especially those that are real world context whereby they want to you to explain. There are a lot of questions. Why not all the people outside? I want to follow them, just go along. Oh, up to you, Lord. Then you fail, it's okay. Oh. It's not my result anyway.
It's your result.
Okay. Chapter 4, okay, done. Okay, formulae is fine. This one you should know. Okay, for inequalities, let me just repeat the inequalities rules. When you plus or minus anything, the sign remains the
same.
When you times or divide by a positive number, the sign remains the same. But when you plus or minus by a negative, when you times or divide by a negative number, the sign will switch. Is that clear? This is very, very important. Understand what I'm saying? Okay. And one more thing is your number line. I must revise this because this class sometimes do until a bit mad already. They don't know how to do it. This is 5, right? This is 4. This is 6, right? So this is the positive side, correct? If I have this, x bigger equals to 5.5. 5.5 will be in the middle, right?
Yes, sir.
And bigger this way, right? It's a solid dot.
Yes.
Understand? Now, if I have x bigger than 5.5,
hollow dot.
Then it will be a hollow dot goes this way, right?
Yeah.
Now, can you not use those felt pen, huh? Like diamond, whether it is solid or not solid, it's no difference. Understand? Huh? Just dot, then you say, if it's hollow, I cannot see anything. It's just like that. That's it. Huh? So can you please indicate carefully, okay? And one more thing, the positive side don't purple. Is this correct?
No.
A lot of people, when they do negative, they also become like that. Because then the brain are burning. It's called brain burn. It's not sun burn, brain burn. What should this be? Tell me.
Minus 5,
minus... Oh, it's correct!
It's
wrong! What should this be?
Minus 6.
Ah, this is negative 4. Hey, your number 9, huh? Do you understand what I'm saying? Because you know why I say this? Even when you draw graph, the negative side, some people also label wrongly. Because though I'm still a bit mad. Okay, cannot be a bit mad. Not to be mad, totally mad, but cannot halfway. Understand? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Can, okay. So this one must be careful, especially your negative side. Okay. So this one I will revise again when I go to set 3, because set 3 got more inequalities, right? Both sides one. Now next one will be on function. This one I can do it next time. Number patterns I'll do it later. Percentage, I think you know what's percentage, right? Now you must know how to convert percentage to fraction, fraction back to percentage. Okay? And then decimal to percentage and percentage back to decimal. I just pulled the set one off just now because you like to do this. Now when I convert, let's say 5/4 to percent, you're actually multiplying by 100%. Because 5 over 4 is 5 over 4 times 100%, right? Which is?
25 times 5.
125%, right?
Yes.
Plus. Now, a lot of you like to present like this. Present this way. Can you tell me what's the difference?
Don't have percent.
Suddenly,
do you know that don't have percent, you're dumb? Multiply 100 is 100 times. When I do this, I'm actually multiplying by what?
100%.
I know it's 100%. It's 100 over 100. So actually multiplying by 1.
It's 100 over 1.
I am not changing anything. I'm just changing the form percentage. You understand what I'm talking about? But when you times 100, you're very clever one. Then suddenly percent come out. Do you know that this is wrong conceptually? You get what I'm saying? So when you change, you must times 100%. Okay. Likewise, if let's say I have 5.25, I want to change to percent. It will be 5.25 times 100%, so it's a 5.25%. Now I think you should know, I'm not that your sector already. 100% means the thing remains the same, right? If it's more than 100%, that means it's more. If it's less than 100%, it means it's less. Okay? Understand? Because this one is 5.25, can you see that it's more than 1?
Yes, sir.
So therefore this percent is more than 100%. Everybody clear?
Yes.
Okay, so percentage. Okay. Now, next will be ratio, rate, and speed. Now, for ratio, I need to warn the class. Okay? Ratio must be in terms of whole numbers. That means it must be like 5 is to 4, 4 is to 1, that kind of thing. Don't have 0.4 is to 0.1, that kind of thing. It cannot be in decimal, it cannot be in fraction. Do you understand? You must convert it to whole number. Is that clear to everyone? Okay. Then, there is this thing that is very scary that students always do not know what I'm talking about. I give you one question and you tell me how to do, okay? Where's the speed? I want to show you this. Okay. Some people I'm very confused when I change to kilometer per hour to meter per second. Okay, I don't know how your teacher has taught you the step one, but I'm going to show you this. Understand? Because if you cannot convert this, it's confirmed data. Okay? Alright. So let's take a look. This is how I do it. If I want to change 30 kilometer per hour to meter per second, right? This is what I'll do. Everybody listen. I know it looks very trivial to you, but if exam you get it wrong, I'm going to throw it out of school as well. Okay? First one. 1 hour travel 30 kilometers, right? 1 hour is how many seconds?
3600
seconds, right? This is 30.123 meter, right? Yeah. Agree? So 1 second will be divided by 3600, right? Okay, how many meters? And everybody use your calculator? Give me a fraction, don't go off. 25 over 3, that's what? 8 meters, right? So this one will be 30 kilometers per hour is actually 8 1/3 meters per second. Can you see? Use this way, it's faster. Don't go and say, wow, what, how many divide, what, then it's very confusing. Do you understand what I'm talking about here? Yes? Okay. Then I want to change, let's say, 30 meters per second to kilometer per hour. I use back the same thing. This one means 1 second, 30 meter. 1 hour is actually 3600 second. Am I right? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So I will take 30 times 3600, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how many meters is this? So,
108
kilometer per hour. Yeah. So, 30 meter per second is actually 108 kilometer per hour. Can you see that?
Yeah.
I use the same concept, you will not get wrong one. Only go and divide times whatever nonsense you have. Just use the one apple cost how much, 20 apple cost how much, you know. Understand what I'm talking about? If you use this way, you will never get it wrong. And I got a high chance this time I come up with one. I ask you to convert, that's all. Okay, and then two marks. What don't you just take? Okay, some of the things are very difficult, you know. Okay, this one cheap 2 marks, you know what? Then vector, you want to go and get 2 marks. Yeah.
Sir, like the 2017, the paper one, right? The inside the mat, the skill, right? It's like linear. Ask for the unit. So it's like 1 is to 0.4 km. And the answer is like
1 is to 0.4 km.
Or 1 cm on the map itself is 0.4 km.
Ah.
Yeah, actually. But then they never like specify what you need to do.
Okay, you see if the scale gives you 1 is to 25,000, right? Let's say it'll be 1 cm represent 25,000 cm. It must be consistent. Okay, it must be safe. CM, CM, meter, meter. But you don't have a map that has 1 meter. That must not go map. You don't say kilometer, kilometer. Then you take a map 1 kilometer. Then how you go to understand? The map scale, don't worry. Set 2, I'm going to go into it. Now it's still set 1. This one, I'll go into it. And I'll also go into square, the area scale. As well, area scale, you're very confused.
Yeah, okay. That one,
you're very confused. So, then the inverse proportion, you're one lucky confused. Increase by 100%, all wrong already. Understand? Okay, so that one, I will go into detail, because paper one, most of these will come up. Okay, so this one, can I go and do it later?
Yes.
Okay, alright, so the ratio part is fine. Okay, now, then I think this one, you're quite good, so I'm not going to go through. Speed is what? Distance divided by?
Time.
Time is what?
Distance
divided by speed. And distance is what?
Speed and time.
Speed times time. This one you should know, So I'm not going to go into that. Okay? Then, I'm going to go into points, lines, and so on and so forth, So I'm going to do this first. Okay. The short forms in your set one, most of you have forgotten and it's very sad, okay? So I'm going to do this part here. Okay. Now, if I have a straight line, A plus B is 180 degrees. What's the reason? It must be called adjacent angles on straight line here. Like that. Now, why must you say adjacent? Adjacent means next to each other. If I draw an angle down here, that is 40 degrees. Then I draw another angle down here, that is 140 degrees. They still add up to 180, but they are not adjacent. They are separated. Adjacent means must be next to each other. You understand? Adjacent angles on straight line. Okay? Now, next. If I have two straight lines intersecting, angle A is equal to angle B, it's called what? Vertically opposite angles. You must know how to write the reason. Must write the reason, okay? Now, next. I have all the rubbish here.
360.
I know 360. A plus B plus C plus D will be 360 degrees because they are angles at a
point.
Everybody clear?
Yes, sir.
Everybody clear? Okay, yeah. Alright. Now, next thing. This should be okay, yeah?
Yeah.
Then I'm going to something else that some people are confused, but you need this in your proving. Emax also will come out. Amax also will come out. Now, when I have two lines and they are parallel, this line that cuts it is called a transversal. Of course, don't need to memorize that, but know that it's a transversal. Next student don't know it's called transversal. Very shameful, I said. Okay. Now, A is equals to B.
Yes.
Right? What is the reason? A is equals to B because of corresponding angles parallel lines. We must say parallel lines. Because corresponding angles, it can be by congruency or similarity. You understand? Okay, next. Angle C is equal to angle B because of
alternate
angles parallel lines. Clear? Okay, now next one. Angle D plus angle B is 180 degrees. Why?
Sum of interior angles.
So long.
Oh shit.
Interior angles parallel lines, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, then I want to talk about the converse of this. Converse means the other way around. Now, if you are given two lines, so I'm going to say it here because I need to improve it. If you are given two lines, they never tell you parallel, they never tell you parallel. Okay. There's one line cutting it. Okay. Now, these two are still corresponding angles. Corresponding angles is by virtue of the position. But they need or need not be equal. Okay? If they're not equal, then this is just two lines and one line. Okay, what if this A and B, so let's say this is 60 degrees. This is also 60 degrees. It will prove that these two lines are parallel. If you can prove that the corresponding angles are equal, that means the two lines that we have drawn up. That you have given you are parallel. Okay? And if you can prove that this angle, let's say you don't know this, you can prove that that one is also 60, that means you have to know what? Alternate angles are equal, right? So these two lines are also
parallel.
Or, what's that? Foul. Don't frighten me like that, okay? My heart, very big. If you can prove that these two add up to 180, these two lines are also parallel. So the other way around is also true. Understand? Now, when people give you two lines, they say this one corresponding angle is true. I don't say don't have parallel line, cannot be corresponding angle, rubbish. Do you understand? These two are also called alternate angles. Just that whether they're equal or not, that's another question. Do you understand? So this is called the converse of the parallel lines and so on. Okay? Just like Pythagoras theorem. If it's right angle, straight away Pythagoras will fit, right? But if you can prove that this side plus this square plus this square equal to this square, then it's a right angle triangle, the other way around. That's called converse. Converse means the other way around. Everybody clear? Everybody clear? So, okay. This one is needed in A maths and B maths. We'll ask you, okay? Alright, now, next one. Plus B plus C is 180 degrees. What's the reason? Not sum.
Angle
sum of triangle. Now it's angle sum of triangle. Not triangle sum of triangle. It's angle is triangle. Okay, don't call it the whole thing. Or triangle sum of angle and also the angle. Now there's never, a lot of people like to write sum of triangle. Why you want to add up all the triangle? No such thing, do you understand? It's angle sum of triangle, okay? Now, next. Do you know that angle C is actually A plus B?
Yes. Exterior angle.
Exterior angle of triangle. Not just exterior angle. Exterior angle of triangle. Okay, so all these short form, you must know, huh? Next. Now, if I do fast,
no.
I'm running off. I do fast also, no choice, okay? I must accelerate, okay? Not accelerate. Okay, so, next one. What is a four-sided figure called? Quadrilateral. Don't call me square, I'm going to okay? Quadrilateral is the major one. It's the universal set. Inside, got square, rectangle, parallelogram, rhombus, all the nonsense down there. Understand? Okay. All the four angles.
Add up 360.
Yes. 360 degrees is called angle sum of what? Quadrilateral. Understand? Don't say I don't know the reason. And quote must spell quote. Don't go and draw one four-sided figure. Then people don't know what is it, okay? Only triangle can use a symbol, you understand? Yeah. Okay, don't anyhow go and draw rubbish, I tell you. Okay? Now next. What is this type of triangle? Isosceles.
I-S-C-O-L-E-S.
I-S-C-O-L-E-S.
Isosceles. So, a lot of people like to write I. A lot of S, I don't know why. S, recurring. S dot. Alright, now. If this is A and this is B, we know that A is equals to B. This is called base angles.
Of an isosceles.
Isosceles triangle. Are you okay? Base angles isosceles triangle. I hope you are fine. Because set 1 really got a lot. Because I need to be from set 1 to set 2. Because your pyramid, cones, spheres are coming, and your prism, okay? Not prism, I'm not going to prism, it's prism, okay? I'm going to explain all that, okay? Because you know why I was saying all this? Because sometimes, you are too used to differentiation, the four different types. You forget the simple type. Then after that, you cannot do, then you say very stress. Maybe there's no stress, okay? Now, next. Are we okay here? Base angles, isosceles triangle. What do you call a triangle with three sides equal?
Equilateral triangle.
Equilateral triangle, right? Equilibrium. What do you call a triangle with three sides all different length? Rubbish. I know it's a triangle. Scalene, okay, now next. Triangle another one is by the angle. Okay? So what do we by acute?
Let's say
angle in triangle.
All
the angles are acute angles.
Yes.
Okay. Right angle is triangle.
90 degrees.
That's what 90 degrees. Now, then can I ask a question? This one is very good when they used to. I want to ask you to explain. Can a triangle have two right angles?
No.
Cannot be. Not two right angles diagonally. It cannot have angles like. Because angles of a triangle is very. Now, obtuse angle triangle means what?
Bigger than 90.
Bigger than 90, yeah, no. Once you have an obtuse angle, the two must be acute already.
Yes.
You understand? Okay. Then, I need to explain this.
Scaly is on.
Acute angle is what? Less than 90, right? More than 0, of course. Less than 90. What do you call something that's right angle?
Right angle.
90 degrees is right angle, right? What do you call something like that?
Obtuse,
right? Obtuse angle. Agree? How to spell obtuse?
O-B-T-U-S.
Alright, because you know what, sometimes you want to know how to spell, they don't want to tell you the spelling, because it's very irritating that you lose one mark because you don't know the spelling. Now, what do you call this type that is more than 360? Less than 360. Reflex. How to spell reflex?
R-E-F-L-E-X.
Yes, reflex angle. Don't do physics 2 until you go and write reflex. Really, some people will write reflex. I don't know why. It's reflex angle, right? Okay, that's how reflex angle. Everybody okay?
Yeah.
Everybody okay so far? Okay, good. At least I've done this. Feel better, okay? Now, next thing. Here comes. Later on, I'm going to go to special collaterals. Converse, what's the property? Okay, because with geometrical proving, the last chapter of AMAX was still with you.
Yeah,
in the movie. But, right now, not yet. I want to do polygons.
Oh my god.
The simplest polygon, ladies and gentlemen,
triangle.
The simplest polygon is triangle. No, three sides. Okay? Four sides is called
Quadrant.
Quadrant is a circle, one quarter is called quadrant. Okay. What is this? Lateral. Five sides.
Pentagon.
Three, four, five.
Hexagon.
Pentagon, I always remember, you know the US one? You know the Pentagon?
Yes.
Now, octopus simulates. I don't know what to call it, so it's octopus. Tentacles, I think so. My name is Omnipo. But I forgot. Okay. What about nine? Nonano? Nonagon? Nine? Ten? Decagon. Not Declan. Okay, so you need to know from 3 to 10 can only. Okay? Understand? Don't have 2! Ayo! How to 4? Alicia?
Yes.
So, decagon, there's no hooligan or whatever. What about things that's more than 10? Usually it's called
more than 10.
11 gun. 12 gun. Then you say, why you so mafan? So called trigger for the fighter. Yeah, can also, but they are special names, so you must know.
Okay. Why?
So 11 gun, 12 gun, 13 gun means they are 13 sides and so on. Now, what do you mean by?
Shusanten.
Regular. Polygon. Regular polygon, not the French fries, okay? Regular polygon means all the sides are equal, all the interior angles are equal. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Okay, let me show you first. You must memorize all these, so until decagon, you know. Now, don't say because October is 10, but this one is 10, then November, then 11, then this one is 12, because some people they go by the months, then they get confused, you know. Okay,
minus two,
that's October, November, December.
This is the dragon.
Then it's different, huh? And the dragon also is have. Because sometimes you are confused. Okay, on up. Do you agree this is a pentagon?
Yeah.
So I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right?
Yes.
Now.
Hexagon.
I draw like that. This is also a pentagon. But this guy is regular. This guy is not regular. Do you understand what I'm saying? Regular means all the sides are the same. All the interior angles are the same. Okay? Understand what I'm talking about. So once you see the word regular, what does it mean? All sides same, all angles same. Okay? Now, then we go on to something that is from your set one, you already know, but I think you forgot all about it. It doesn't matter. I'm going to show you. Now, a triangle, all the angles add up to 180.
Yep.
A quadrilateral, you know,
360.
Why? Because I can divide into two divisions.
Yep.
So 180 times 2.
Okay.
What I mean is the sum of all the interior angles. Everybody okay? Now, for pentagon,
is
that right? Can you see that I can divide into three triangles?
Yeah.
So it's 180 times 3, right? All the angles add up together. I know it's 540. I'm not interested in the 540. You can use it for the calculator.
Yes.
So actually, if a polygon has got n sides, the sum of interior angles is actually n minus 2 times 180. The sum of all the interior angles. Why? Now, if it's a triangle, I prove to you, if it's a triangle, n is how much? 3, right? If it's like 3 minus 2 is what? 1. So it's 180. Then for a quadrilateral, how many sides? 4. 4 minus 2 is what? 2 times 180. That's why it's 360. Then for a pentagon, how many sides? 5. So 5 minus 2 times 180. 3. Understand? 3 times 480, 540. Understand? Now, what if I have a pentagon? So the sum of all the interior angles will be 20 minus 2 times 480. It's the sum of all the interior angles. Now, let me just tell you something that a lot of people are confused with. Later I'll give you the formula, don't worry. I just want to know what I'm talking about first. Now, do you agree that these two are all pentagons?
Yes.
Okay. So sum of all the interior angles for both are the same. That means sum of interior angles will be 5 minus 2 times 180, right?
Yeah.
So this is 540 degrees, right?
Yeah.
Now what's the difference? This one means I can divide by 5, I can get 1.
Yep.
This one I cannot do anything.
Yep.
Unless I know 4 of them. Then I can find the big one. Do you understand? Because this guy is not regular. This guy is regular. Everybody clear? Okay, now, next up, I give you the formula over here. Sum of interior angles of an angle will be n minus 2 times 180 degrees. Okay, regardless of whether regular or irregular, whatever nonsense you have. It is not irregular anyway. Okay. Alright, now what is the sum of all exterior angles of any polygon is always 360 degrees. All the exterior angles are always added up into 360 degrees regardless of the number of sides. Understand what I'm talking about here? Where are the exterior angles? Okay. This is the interior, right? Exterior angle will be here. This will be the exterior angle. Understand? So what does it mean? One interior angle plus one exterior angle must give you
180
degrees because they are adjacent angles on
straight line.
This is important. Everybody clear? Can or cannot? Because I'm going to give you a paper one question that is very popular. I'm going to show you a shortcut. You can also use long cut, it doesn't matter. Your class are shortcut, long cut also doesn't matter, but I think the long cut will be mistake. Understand? So I'm going to write the question on the board now. I hope this is useful to you.
Yeah.
Because you forgot everything. Okay. Yeah, I forget one. Look at your face also, you forget.
Maybe the.
Go. got learn ah, come on ah. Yourself teacher try so hard and
never learn before. Maybe we never listen to that one.
I think that here she left already, sir.
I'll ask Junie later.
I think by that time...
Oh, Junie is not in school today. Tomorrow I'll ask her. Oh, so is there someone called Apple G in your class? Most likely she will wonder who is Apple. Now say that one who eat Apple during math lesson, you know? And crunch in front of him, that kind of thing.
No,
like nobody's business like that.
The water.
The water. You say I never say, huh?
Yeah.
Did I say water? I never say. He said himself.
Never eat apple
instead one. I don't know. I don't know what's water.
You never eat apple instead
one. Oh, you never eat apple instead one.
Yeah. You just tell her the water one.
No, I'll say the water one.
Your house
also water made. Straight away use the exterior angle. Do you understand? Faster. You don't see your problem. It's definitely faster. Okay? Now, then I want to try one question for me. Alright? Okay. Are you okay so far? Yes, because I have some more to go. Because the set 3, set 4, 1 I can go faster, it's more recent. The set 1, 1 I don't go this one because I forgot entirely. Okay? Alright. Question 3, yeah? Can you try this?
Thank you.